This is an outstanding definition. This is the sixth president of the United States, John Quincy Adams. He passed away in 1840 something. He was the president for one term. It's over 125, 130 years since he died. Look at what he said. Your action must inspire others. So everybody who works with you must one day nurse the ambition of being in your chair. You have to get people to dream more, learn more, do more. So how many people in your branch or your bank are pursuing a higher education or a qualification? How much are you encouraging? How much are you facilitating? If somebody is wanting to give an internal departmental exam, which I'm sure you have, how many of us have the ability to spend half an hour after the bank or branch closes with that young person and tell them, come and sit with me in the office, kitab kholo, now your job as a cashier or teller or whatever it is done. Now let's discuss how you prepare for your exam. How many of us have a large office and we say, okay, I want 5 people to do their next level of post-graduation over the next 6 months. And I'll help you do it. I'll find the teacher, I'll find the mentor, I'll find the institute, and I'll give you the time. That is what it means about getting people to become more. You do that and you become a leader. So what has got inserted in this definition is this little attribute of selflessness. Apna thoda sa waqt, give a little bit of your time to somebody else every day. That is what makes a leader apart from just a manager. And that is what all of us must do.